The Adopt a Highway Foundation gives everyone a chance to keep Texas highways beautiful and care for them as if they were their own. Volunteers can adopt a 2-mile stretch of highway for a minimum of 2 years and agree to pick up litter 4 times a year. For more information, visit the URL provided.
I don't light it. It'll weigh the hammer on the hands, stay on play. Give it up, Jiggy, make it feel like foreplay. Yo, my cardio is infinite. Ha-ha, Big Willie Styles all in it. Getting Jiggy with it. Getting Jiggy with it. Getting Jiggy with it. Getting Jiggy with it. You on the ball with your kid, watch your step, you might fall, trying to do what I did. Mama, come close side, in the middle of the club with the rubber dub. No love for the haters, mad cause I got floor seats at the Lakers. See me on the 50-yard line with the Raiders, met Ali, he told me I'm the greatest. I got the fever for the flavor of a crowd pleaser, DJ play another. From the president, sure highness, only bad chicks, riding my whip. South to the west, to the east, to the north, bump my hips and watch them go off, but go off, but yes, yes, sure. And you don't stop in the winter order.
Summertime.
I mix it high, getting jiggy with them. Getting jiggy with it. Getting jiggy with it. Getting jiggy with it. 850 IS, if you need a lift. Who's the kid in the drop? Who else will slip? Living that life, some consider a myth. Rock from South Street to 125th. Women used to tease me, give it to me now, nice and easy. Since I moved up like Georgia Wheezy. Cream to the maximum, I'll be axing them. Would you like to bounce with your brother that's platinum? Never see Will attacking them. Rather play ball with Shaq and them. Flatten them, like getting. Thought I took a spell, but I didn't. Trust the lady of my life, she hitting. Hit her with a drop top with the ribbon. Crib for my mom on the outskirts of Philly. You trying to flex on me? Don't be silly. Getting jiggy with it. Getting jiggy with it. Getting jiggy with it. Getting jiggy with it.
college seniors are preparing to enter the next chapter of their lives. It's time to celebrate, but there's a challenge awaiting them too. They need to find work, and entry-level jobs are hard to come by. According to the Economic Policy Institute, 53.6% of those under the age of 25 who have a bachelor's degree were jobless or underemployed last year. However, Texas State student Eli Justice is keeping a positive attitude about the job market.
It's always a new chapter. So, I mean, there is, there's some uncertainties. But I'm pretty optimistic about, you know, going to the workforce, graduating, knowing that I've built myself as a person individually, academically, to go out and compete in the job market.
Another Texas State senior, Andrew Henley, has a job opportunity after graduation, but he has mixed emotions.
I'm really optimistic. There's a job offer in Houston that I'm really looking into, as well as some opportunities in San Antonio, which I'm kind of holding out for. But no matter what, you know, how it works out, I'll be okay.
Students at Texas State are both hopeful and fearful about what lies ahead after graduation. But most seniors, like myself, are really excited to see what challenges will come our way. For Bobcat Update, I'm Caitlin Moore.
We join our hero today as he embarks on a brave new journey. Not afraid to stare danger right in the eyes, it's exactly what this flyboy lives for. As this brave young man and his fellow pilots climb aboard their fighter jets, not knowing whether they will live to see another day, these men find a needed bit of comfort in closing their eyes and remembering why they pursued the profession in the first place.
For God and country, I will do what I can to protect you.
After experiencing the joy of flying, men will walk with his eyes turned skyward.
For the chicks, dude!
This is a coming of age. This is an era not seen before. This is The Gimme Boys, starring Lieutenant Billy Ted.
Enter.
Good afternoon, Colonel Spoonfed. Lieutenant Billy Ted reports as ordered.
About time. Have a seat.
What's the problem, Broseph?
Excuse me?
Sir, what concerns you?
That's a little better. Anyway, LT, your flying hasn't been something most people can put their finger on. You know it. Your wingmen know it. Hell, even your mom knows it.
Sir, I can explain.
I haven't seen someone try to twist the art of combat into their own leisurely game like this since the Academy increased their graduate pool when I was only an 03.
Sir, really?
I have been discussing your performance with the wing commander, and quite frankly, we are both completely baffled.
I can explain.
There will be no need for explanations. Clearly, you're on to something that no one else has been able to figure out. You've rewritten the rules of the fight, boy. It seems you've put fear on the back burner and have mastered the art of having the upper hand.
Really?
Believe it, sonny!
Wow, and here I was thinking I was gonna get extra duty for stealing stuff from the snack bar.
What?
Nothing. Just thought you might want to hear a joke.
There's no time for that nonsense. This is a pivotal moment for you, me, and, well, the entire Air Force.
What do you mean, sir?
Lieutenant, I wasn't so sure about it at first, but I've got no other choice. I'm sending you, but hopefully not your character, to look at hot buns.
Do you mean you're sending me to Top Gun?
Huh? What? Hot bun? What the hell does... Was I drunk when I wrote this? I can't make out a word of it. Ah, colonels don't make mistakes, son.
All right, dude, whatever.
For the next 6 months, you'll be flying and fighting with the best of the best. You'll be pushed to your limits. And when you've made it through it all, you will be the most elite that our military has to offer. And remember, there's no points for second race.
Sir, I'm offended. I know we have a generational gap between us, but does the civil rights movement mean anything to you?
Huh? No points for second? Oh, place. When you leave, could you tell my secretary, Judy, to get me a new pen? Or maybe just have her put less scotch in my coffee. Yeah, that should do the trick. Anyway, generals don't make mistakes.
Sir, I thought you were a colonel.
That's enough, LT! You'll be departing tomorrow at 0600. Congratulations, airman.
Thanks, I think. To see hot buns, huh? That old fart is either a perv or senile. Jeez.
Judy, where's my champagne bottle? I left it in the top drawer yesterday. This is BS. You're lucky you're a civilian.
On second thought, raging alcoholic seems to sum it up pretty well.
All right, here goes nothing. Wow, we're up. It's beautiful out there.
Rise and shine, Teddy boy. Surprise attack. Show me what you got. Fight's on.
Dude, not cool. I was totally in the zone and everything. It's such a buzzkill.
This is your chance to prove you're worthy of being here at Hot Buns.
Dude, what is up with the whole Hot Buns thing?
Never mind, it's not important. Fight, fight, fight!
Chat slow. Chat slow. Pull up, pull up. Block.
Thug Nasty 1-1, knock it off. Fight's over. Thug Nasty 1-1, confirmed kill. Winner.
Mama, you're actually a fine pilot.
Thanks, Bromeister. I appreciate it.
What did you call me?
Nothing, old dude.
You should be proud. You really proved you're more than a give-me boy today.
Well, if I get a victory dance, then I want to rock it to some tunes. I think there's something wrong with this tape.
Hey, that's my little jaw cassette. I've been looking for that. Take it out and give it back to me when we're back at base.
All right, boss man. Let me just hit the eject button so I won't forget to take it out.
And so our tale ends. Not with a whimper, but a bang. Actually, it more likely ends with both. Our hero, Lieutenant Billy Ted, was not injured in his accidental activation of the aircraft's rocket-powered ejection seat, but he was severely distraught by the fact that he would never be able to return General Wayne's cassette tape to him. Lieutenant Ted is a remorseful person, and feeling as though he had deeply wronged General Wayne, he slipped into a severe depression for the next few years. However, our hero's remorse and empathy is what makes him such a noble, admirable person. In fact, his character is what rewarded him with a gift he had never even dreamed of. 5 years later, Lieutenant Ted stumbled upon a box set collection of Little John cassette tapes at an entertainment store and purchased them for General Wayne. General Wayne was so overjoyed with this act of kindness that he appointed Lieutenant Ted as the new chief instructor for the Top Gun program and gave him the necessary security clearance to grant him access to Hot Buns, the Air Force's prestigious top secret hamburger shop. Lieutenant Ted instructed at Top Gun for decades to come and produced some of the finest pilots the Air Force had ever seen. With their special blend of skills, their unique sense of morale, and their otherworldly style of character, these aviators turned the Air Force into an absolutely invulnerable powerhouse, gaining the utmost of respect worldwide. And these flyboys were proud to call themselves Gimme Boys.
Gimme boys, tanks and planes, our favorite toys. Gimme all of it tonight. We got no place to go inside. We'll get messed up and start a fight and end up in the beds of ugly girls. Everybody now,
we are the Gimme Boys. Thanks for playing our favorite toys.
Night, night.
Yeah!
We got no place to go inside. Get messed up and start a fight and end up in the beds of ugly girls.